Oh, that was very nice. I've missed that sound.
It's okay.
A month ago, Chuck Heron called me and said, "What are we going to do about your birthday?" I said, "Well, I'm not playing right now because I have arthritis." And he said, "Well, we'll do something." So Chuck is a very creative and inventive guy. And I said, "Okay, let's do something." And this is what happened with something. So I'm sorry we didn't make enough programs, but if you're next to somebody with a program, you could take your phone out, make a copy. Or you could complain on the way out. Okay? So I just think you're going to get your dollar's worth tonight with all these wonderful people who said they'd come and play. So to start off, Chuck Heron and Dave, the bass player with the beard. So let's give him a hand. Thank you. Next, we have a group that I called Trio Basso. And I enjoyed very much when I was younger playing symphony orchestras. The sound of the cellos and the basses when they had something beautiful to play and they were up for playing something beautiful, which is another thing. But two of these friends in this performance are musicians I knew in Hartford, Connecticut, which was where we lived and all. And so Glenn Campbell is an old friend. I've known him for years. And I'm happy that he's here. And then Mark Olscher has some work with me. And it's good to see him. You're playing Purcell and Bach?
Bach and Purcell.
Bach and Purcell, that's different.
Say, well, you know.
Thank you.
our work. Ladies and gentlemen, and those of you who have a program, you'll notice that the wonderful Miss Shadowlight is scheduled, but somehow she isn't here. So what we're going to do is move on with the program. And we have the string trio here with Andrea, Francesca, and Lori. And they're going to play a favorite tango of mine. Oh, good. Don't break anything. And then we're going to have another Piazzolla tango with piano, violin, and cello from Summer. I first saw and heard the music of Piazzolla at the Darmstadt Festival in Darmstadt, Germany, of course. And I went to the music store and I picked up a book, and I've been in love ever since. I think you'll enjoy these. And now your heart is warmed up with those low sounds, and you're warm, and you don't let the breeze bother you. Hello. Okay, so when the cellist decides to come back, we'll have a concert.
Take the microphone away.
That was my son. And we're not going to take him home tonight.
I have a little story to tell about why you're seeing me so many times in so many groups. When I came out here to do my graduate work because Bert said I should come to UCSD after I finished HARC, I was his TA for chamber music. And he liked to have, he's brilliant at knowing all kinds of different combinations of instruments. Because in his chamber music class, we didn't just have like a string trio or a string quartet. He's brilliant at figuring out what instruments were there and what music they could play. And so I was his TA, and he liked to do long concerts because he had big classes. We did one set of concerts that was a Friday night, a Saturday afternoon, and a Sunday afternoon. But the one that I remember the most was one, I think it was a Tuesday night, and the basses for his bass ensemble played from 5 to 7, and then the chamber music class started the concert at 7 o'clock, and we finished somewhere around 2 o'clock in the morning. And I was in 7 different pieces because he had put me in 7 different groups. Yeah, thank you very much. So that's why you're seeing me so much tonight, which is actually a delight. So this is called Oblivion, and actually it was an arrangement by Jeff Pekarek, who also studied bass with Bert.
Mm-hmm.
And now another of Piazzolla's wonderful tangos. He made a set called Four Seasons. And we all know where that came from. And if we don't, we should. So, there. And now Stephen Gray is the pianist, and Elise Dreiling will be the violinist. And guess who is playing cello?
I wonder.
Come on!
Piazzolla definitely is the master. And next we have a wonderful combination of my favorite instrument. What's better than one bass? Two basses. What's better than two basses? That's right. And this is the bass ensemble from UCSD, led by Professor Mark Dresser, who I've had the pleasure of knowing for over 50 years. And we're still friends. I like that very much. And I appreciate him and all his work. He has been quite a figure in this instrument growing and going everywhere. And he'll probably do this for another 50 years. Is that right, Mark?
We'll see.
Okay, that's good. And Matthew is over here. And then Catherine has got a different shade bass. Yeah, very good. She's got a fancy bass stool. All right. So without any more kibitzing, you all know what that means. And we'll have... Okay. Did you get that for us, please?
Thank you. Sorry about that. Thank you.
Is that okay? All right, ladies and gentlemen, they're getting their stuff together. Notice how many different colors these instruments are. and how they blend. Wonderful. The king and queen of orchestra instruments. UCSD bass ensemble.
Ensemble, we play new music written for us once a year by a graduate and also by members of the ensemble. And we're going to start off tonight playing a brand new piece, never been performed, by Catherine Schulmeister. And this is Matthew Henson.
Thank you.
when I was a student at UCSB, Bert showed me a scale, all in harmonics. And it was, I think it was. So this is between the fourth and the sixth harmonic. And so for the last few weeks, I've been obsessing between harmonics, between a half step. And the harmonics you get there are the 6, 7, 8, 9. So I decided to write a piece called 6, 7, 89 Birthday.
Thank you.
Mark?
Yeah.
That will be a hell of a birthday party, man. I must tell you that. Bravo, bass players. Yeah. And now, ladies and gentlemen, after that rip-roaring birthday party, oh, I should like to go to it. Really. I spent 32 years teaching at UCSD, and I met many interesting people who visited, and faculty. Among the really delightful and gifted faculty was this guy who came from Yale. And I see that he won a Pulitzer Prize as a composer, and an opera of his based on Malcolm X will be at the Met next year. How about that? And then he plays the piano just beautifully. So let's give Tony Davis some applause so we'll find out the piano. Thank you. and a lot of success playing with. And tonight I'm going to listen to a small version of this marvelous group. Growing up in Connecticut, I played in Polish bands. I played in Greek bands. And I played in klezmer bands. That came naturally because I am a member of that race. And when Deborah Davis, the fine soprano, invited me to join this ensemble, I was delighted because I knew the marvelous clarinetist Robert Seligman would be there. There he is. Yeah, there he is. And Ellen Wells is going to play the piano. Like your hand too. And you're going to sing, aren't you?
Yes.
We look forward to it. Thank you so much for coming tonight.
You're welcome.
Jamie is here.
I chose this first song because Bert has told us over the years this was his mother Tilly Tereschi's favorite song, Shane Vi Dilavone, which means you are as beautiful as the moon. When I saw you, I could not believe how gorgeous you were, as beautiful as the moon. Like the moon above you, the stars remind me of you. The angels knew I love you, so heaven sent you to me. And it just, there was a very famous actor in the Yiddish theater, and his name was Menashe Skolnik. And this little bit of tid, I just realized, it said Menashe Skolnik used to say that this song was written for him to sing. But now that it's a big hit and everyone sings it, he doesn't sing it anymore. He has stopped. Number 85.
I see you know that joke.
Yeah.
Der Moich ist mir zu mir. Ich geh an sich hier. Ich weiß allein nicht, was ich will. Zusammen dir hast du mich.
Thank you.
going the wrong way. I'm going the right way. I'm going the Jewish way, and it doesn't work that way in this book.
So I'm thinking,
what was it, 47?
I'm thinking that it was 1989. Husband Bob and I moved from New York, met some of these wonderful people, went over, I believe that's the first time I met you, Bert. I eventually meandered my way over to UCSD, as did many of us.
And gave me a B.
like a magnet, And I was thinking today, a lot of people call me Dr. Weller because of this strange shape of a shoe on my backside. And the reason I was able to finish everything and get where I am, really, thank you, Maestro. I think a lot of us have gone a long way on his energy, and still throwing it out.
No, I did not yet. This song is called Hopkele, which means a little hop or a little dance, and it says, boys and girls, take hands and dance a little hop under the chuppah, which is the Jewish marriage canopy, because life is only a game. Hopkele.
Inspired me, but Bert has inspired Nancy. When I first saw him play his bass at the Bass Summit, along with Mark Dresser, I realized that a string instrument can be a solo instrument, and it started me on a rabbit hole. And hearing you make sounds on that bass that I didn't really think were possible, you know, said, and the Native Americans often say that, you know, they use every piece of the buffalo, and I felt like watching Bert play that I was watching somebody use every part of the buffalo, which is a bass. And so, along with Mark Dresser, who inspired me watching him move water. Hi.
Hi.
So just give me a moment to set up. I'll just take a second. So what I'm going to do is a short little loop piece. I've been doing these, so basically the roots of what you're going to hear comes from these two men. And as we all know, Mark, sorry, I just really stepped out. Anybody want to tell a story why I take a minute to set up? Anybody got a great story? Okay, so I also had the honor of doing the back cover and a little bit of artwork. I've done a lot of the posters for these birthdays. So it's quite an honor to be here. There's just one more plug I gotta set up. I just played at an event up in LA, and I ran down here as fast as I could. So, one more cable.
We've all been there, setting up.
Have you? Yeah, usually it's smoother and more elegant than this, but I'll have to do. Here we go. I need a roadie. That's what I need.
Don't we all?
So I started my solo journey, I guess it's been 5 years, and I'm just really very, very grateful for all you've done for music and soul. Your phone calls every once in a while just really brighten up my day.
Thank you. Thank you. some of the happiest times of my life were spent with you. And while I test the microphone, let me just read for you one of the poems that we performed together. Okay, from that Dada strain. The zigzag, mothers of the gods of science, the lunatic fixed stars and pharmacies, fathers who left the tents of anarchism unguarded, the arctic bones strung out on Saint-Germain, like tom-toms, living light bulbs, aphrodisia. Art is junk, the urinal says. Dig a hole and swim in it. A message from the grim computer. We are hamburger. What Mark and I are going to perform is a work in progress called In the Shadow of a Mad King, and a shadow that we're living under at present, and a section of that called Lies. In the Shadow of a Mad King. How beautiful a lie is when the truth won't rhyme, letting a mad king's voice come back to him, sounding his own name twice. Sees a mad king everywhere he looks. The time to end the time draws closer while the lie lives on. Out of his mind and ours, the mad king rages, casting all hope aside, the phantoms of the past, reborn as lies. Nothing to focus on, but what his skewed mind shows a mad king, veneration of a dying world, empty of any sound but howls and lies. Lies he tells, delights a mad king. In and out his tiny hands fly, down his swollen mouth, and troll the lie that chokes him. faces of the twice betrayed, the ones who wait on a mad king, ready to take his taste his lies, and never breaking faith. Mad king pries the skin loose from those who spurn him, not in his mind alone, but reaching a lost kingdom where a lie rings true. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, I would like to thank all the wonderful performers who gave us a night that I'll never forget. And while I'm talking, I should tell you that the local music critic, George Varga, who was one of the good guys, hey, what are you doing? Oh, God. George Varga said that I was 80 years old, and I'm not. I'm 89 years old. Thank you and good night.